parents, including Cherie. Grab your sunscreen and the little ones. It's time to head back to the pool.
Yeah, we checked, and the restrictions have been lifted over in northern Kentucky at your local pool. And News 4's Cheryl Parker joining us now from Union with the very latest on the Shigella outbreak. Cheryl?
Cherie and Jack, parents here in Union are just getting the word that the restrictions have been lifted. They were in place for almost a month, and health officials say since they stopped allowing children who weren't potty trained to be in the pools, they've seen a decrease in the number of Shigella cases. Well, now those little ones who are still in diapers can be in the water, but parents need to take some measures to make sure they're keeping their kids safe from illness. Take a look at some of those things that parents need to be mindful of. If a child has been sick with diarrhea, don't have them in the pool for at least 2 weeks after the diarrhea stops, even if they are feeling better. Don't swallow pool water. Practice good hygiene. Shower before swimming. Wash the child thoroughly and wash your hands after using the toilet and changing diapers. Take frequent bathroom breaks and change diapers in the bathroom, not when you are beside the pool. Now, once again, parents are happy because some of them have not been able to bring their little ones to the pool, but they can do that now because those restrictions have been lifted. But parents are urged to make sure they're using precautions and proper hygiene. Cheryl Parker, News 5.
Before you leave us, I know that pools, we've been talking so much about pools and the pools being closed down in northern Kentucky, but there are other places that health officials have concerns, correct?
Yes, in fact, they are also targeting child care centers, and any licensed child care center in northern Kentucky should have received some information about proper sanitizing of their daycare homes and facilities and proper hand washing, all the things that we talk about that will help prevent the spread of this illness. Cherie?
All right, Cheryl Parker live for us, and health officials do think that it started in the daycare. So again, take that seriously. Okay, so what are the signs that you might have Shigella? Diarrhea, fever, stomach cramps, nausea, or vomiting. Some cases, though, don't show any symptoms at all. So if you think that your kids may have been exposed, call your doctor and don't go swimming in public pools.
New tonight.